ICTSI and its Honduras unit take the government of the Central American nation to an arbitration body. It's said today that the International Center for Settlement of Investment Disputes formally registered its arbitration request. This followed the Honduran government's move to denounce a treaty of the ICSID back in February. It alleged Honduras breached certain obligations, details of which remain scant. The company of Port Sycoon Enrique Razon, however, said day-to-day operations in Honduras are unaffected and it remains open to discussions with the government for solutions. Next to ASIN Corporation, it signed last week a deal with Gen Zero and Keppel to help retire coal-fired power plants in Southeast Asia. The three parties will explore the use of carbon credits to finance the decommissioning of the power plant of South Luzon Thermal Energy Corporation in Batangas. The initiative will seek to replace it with a clean energy dispatch facility in 10 years.
Aftershocks are expected in northern Samar after magnitude 5.7 quake rocked the province Monday morning. Sharon Evite now joins us on the line for more on this story. Good afternoon, Sharon. Go ahead.
Yes, Sandy. Residents in the downtown area of Pasbalagan City, Samar, panicked and went out of buildings this noon after a strong earthquake struck. In Kataraman, northern Samar, the tremor caused glass windows of a fast food chain inside a department store to shatter. In a grocery store in Barangay Pulangi in Kataraman, canned goods fell off the shelves as the ground shook. Meanwhile, students at Leyte Normal University in Tacloban City rushed to open areas for safety. According to TVOX, Northern Samar experienced at least 10 tremors this afternoon. The strongest quake registered at a magnitude of 5.7, with its epicenter in the town of Pambuhan at 11:39 a.m. The tremors were felt in the towns of Bobon, Catarman, Lauang, Labisares, Palapag, Rosario, and San Roque in northern Samar, and also in several towns in eastern Samar, Leyte, southern Leyte, Sorsogon, Albay, Catanduanes, Masbate, Camarines, and Cebu. EVOX continues to monitor the seismic activity in northern Samar, with aftershocks being recorded up until 1:39 this afternoon. Although these aftershocks were detected, no intensity levels were recorded. EVOX, however, has warned of possible further aftershocks and reminded the public to remain calm and follow the advice of local officials. In response to the continuous threat of aftershocks, Kataraman Northern Samar Mayor Antet Rosales has ordered the suspension of classes at all levels in the entire town today. The decision was made to prioritize the safety of students and school personnel. This will also allow the Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office to conduct assessments in barangays affected by the quake to determine the extent of damages and necessary assistance.
All right, thank you so much for the update, Sharon Evita. The fog from Taal affecting the air quality in Metro Manila and Calabarzon. Based on the monitoring of the Environment Department this morning, stations in various locations logged very unhealthy air quality. FIVOC said Taal emitted more than 3,300 tons of sulfur dioxide, which were carried by winds blowing northwestward. Now, health experts are advising the public, especially those living near the volcano, to wear N95 masks. Meanwhile, tropical storm Dindo, with international name Jongdari, which formed Sunday evening over the northern Philippine Sea, has exited the Philippine area of responsibility this morning. However, its rain bands may still bring scattered rains over Batanes and the Babuyan Islands.